Good afternoon, students. Now today we will start a new topic, equivalent fraction. Now fraction having same value are called equivalent fractions. For example, 1/2, 2/4, 3/6, etc. These are equivalent fractions. Why? Because when we simplify 2/4, we get 1/2. And when we simplify 3/6, we get 1/2. Okay? Therefore, 1/2, 2/4, 3/6 are equivalent fractions. Understand? To find equivalent fraction, we use multiplication and division both. If we find equivalent fraction of 1/2, then 1/2 multiply by 2 and 2. Both numerator and denominator by same non-zero numbers, 2/4. 2/4 is equivalent fraction of Again, 1/2 is equal to 1 multiplied by 3, 2 multiplied by 3, 3/6. 3/6 also equivalent fraction. Therefore, 1/2, 2/4, 3/6 are equivalent fraction. We get these equivalent fraction by multiplying by same non-zero number in numerator and denominator of a fraction. Okay. Now second, by dividing. By dividing 2/4/12. Okay. Now 4 divided by 2 and 12 divided by 2, we get 2/6. 2/6 is a equivalent fraction of 4/12. And we get it by dividing same non-zero number of fraction 4/12. Okay. Here you see that numerator 4 divided by 2 and denominator 12 divided by 2. We get 2/6. Okay. Again, 4/12 is equal to 4 divided by 4 and 12 divided by 4. Here you get 1/3. 1/3 also equivalent fraction of 4/12. Therefore, in this way we find the equivalent fraction of a given fraction. Okay. Simplest form of a fraction. Okay. A fraction is said to be in simplest form or lowest form if its numerator and denominator have no common factor except one. For example, 1/2, 2/3, 5/6, etc. Are in simplest form or lowest form because its numerator and denominator have no common factor other than one. Okay. Understand? If we take common factor of 1 and 2, we get 1. 2 and 3, we get 1. 5 and 6, we get 1. Therefore, these fractions are examples of simplest form of a fraction. Okay? Exercise 7.21. Write the fraction are all these equivalent. Okay. Here you see that 4 circle. First circle half parts are said. Therefore fraction 1/2. circle divided in four parts, therefore denominator 4, and sided part 2, therefore fraction 2 upon 4. All parts in circle 6, therefore numerator 6, sided part 3, therefore fraction 3 upon 6. Here you see that all parts of circle, how much? 1, 2, 3, 4, 8, and sided part 4. Okay? Therefore fraction 4 upon. Here you see that all the fraction 1 upon 2, 2 upon 4, 3 upon 6, and 4 upon 8. Understand? Having same value. Therefore, these are equal. It means that if we multiply 4, numerator and denominator, we get equivalent fraction. Now, 4 2 ja 8, and 4 7 ja 28. Understand? Now in B, 5 2 ja 10. It means that 2 multiply, therefore 2 8 ja 16. 3 upon 5. 20 blank. 5 4 ja 20. We divide 20 by 5. 5 4 ja 20. Therefore we multiply 4 to 3. We get 12. In D, 45 15. It means that 45 divided by, first we divide 45 by 15, we get 3. Means that 45 divided by 3, we get 15, and 60 divided by 3, we get 20. Understand? Now in the E, 18 upon 24, 18 upon 24, 4, 6, 24, 6, if we divide 24 by 6, we get 4, then we also divide 18 by 6, we get 3. Okay? Good afternoon, friend. Now today, we will start exercise 7.2. Now, our first topic, representation of fraction on the number line. We can show every fraction on the number line. Okay? With the help of example, we learn how we represent fraction on the number line. Now first we show 1 upon 2 on the number line. Okay. Now here you see that 1 upon 2. 1 upon 2 is a proper fraction. Because its numerator is less than denominator. So it always lies between 0 and 1. Okay? Understand? Now we divide the gap between 0 and 1 in two equal parts. Now we divide the gap between 0 and 1 in two equal parts. Half part here and half part here. Now when we represent 1 upon 2, we write 1 upon 2 in the middle of 0 and 1. Okay? Now, next, to represent 3 by 2. 3 by 2, improper fraction. Because its numerator is greater than denominator. To represent an improper fraction on the number line, first we convert into mixed fraction. Okay? When we convert into mixed fraction, it is like 1 whole number 1 upon 2. This shows that 3 upon 2 is greater than 1. Greater than 1. And its fractional part 1 upon 2 lie between 1 and 2. 1 and 2. Okay. Now we divide 1 and 2. 1 and 2. Gap between 1 and 2 in 2 equal parts. Half part here, half part. Now this position show 3 upon 2. Okay. In this way, we represent all fractions on the number line, which is proper or improper. Understand? Now, our next topic, proper fraction, improper fraction and mixed fraction. Okay. In proper fraction, numerator is always less than denominator. For example, 1 upon 2, 2 upon 3, 99 upon 100, etc. These are example of proper fraction. Here you see that numerator, upper part is numerator and lower part is denominator. Numerator is always less than 1 is less than 2, 2 is less than 3, 99 is less than 100. Okay. In improper fraction, numerator is bigger than denominator. For example, 3 by 2. 5 by 6, 5 by 4, 100 upon 99, etc. These are the examples of improper. Here you see that numerator 3, 5, 100 always greater than its own denominator. 3 is greater than 2, 5 is greater than 4, 100 is greater than 99. Okay. Now mixed fraction. A mixed fraction is a combination of a whole and a part. For example, 1 whole number 1 upon 2, 3 whole number 2 upon 5, 6 whole number 1 upon 3, dot dot dot, etc. Understand? This is the whole and this is part. Whole, part. Whole, part. Okay? Now, 1 whole number 1 upon 2. Represent a whole number, a mixed fraction. 3. Now, student, we start exercise 7.2. Question number 1, draw number line. Number lines and locate the points. Locate the points on them. Okay? Now here first we draw number line. This is the number line. Now we take here 0, 1, 2 and 4. Okay. Now here you see that all fractions are proper fraction. Now it is always lie between 0 and 1. 0 and 1. Okay, now we divide. Here you see that denominator 4. Now we divide 0 and 1 in 4 parts. 4 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 equal parts. Now first part will represent 1 by 4. Second, 2 by 4. Third, 3 by 4. And fourth, 4 by 4. Understand? 2 by 4 is equal to 1 by 2. This represent 1 by 2. Okay? In this way, we represent 1 by 2, 1 by 4, 3 by 4 and 4 by 4. Okay. Now in question number B, first again we draw a number line. We take 0 here, 1, 2 and so on. Okay. Here you see that denominator 8. Now we divide the gap between 0 and 1 in 8 equal parts. 8 equal parts. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Now we count it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 equal parts. Now, first part 0, 1 upon 8. Okay. Second, 2 upon 8. Third, 3 upon 8. Okay. Third part means this part. 2 upon 8, this part. 1 upon 8, this part. Now, 7 part 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And this represents 7 upon 8. Okay. Now come on question number C. First we draw again a number line. We take 0 and 1, 2 and so on. Here you see that denominator 5. Now we divide the gap between 0 and 1 in 4, 5 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 equal parts. Now first represent 1 upon 5. Second, 2 upon 5. Third, 3 upon 5. Four upon 5. And here you see that improper fraction. 8 upon 5. First, we convert into mixed fraction. 8 upon 5. 1 whole number 3 upon 5. 1 whole number 3 upon 5. Now, here we see that 8 upon 5 always lie between 1 and 2. Okay. Now we divide 1 and 2 in 3 equal parts, 5 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now this represents 1. 1 whole number 1 upon 5, 1 whole number 2 upon 5, 1 whole number 3 upon 5. This part is 1 whole number 3 upon 5 or 8 upon 5. Understand? In this way we represent the fraction on the number line. Okay? Now to express the following as mixed fraction. Okay, here you see that 20 upon 3, first we divide 20 by 3. 3 6 ja 18, 2. Now we can write 6 whole number 2 by 3. In this way, 11 upon 5, 5 2 ja 10, a plus 10, 2 whole number 1 upon 5. 17 upon 7, 7 2 ja 14. 2 whole number 3 upon 7, 28 upon 5. Okay, first we divide 28 by 5, 5 5 ja 25, 3, 5 whole number 3 upon 5, 19, 6 3 ja 18 and 1, 3 whole number 1 upon 6, 35, 9, 9 3 ja 27, 8. Now 3 whole number 8 upon 9. Okay. Now question number 3. Express the following as improper fraction. Here you see that mixed fraction. Now first we multiply 4 7 ja 28 or plus 3 31 upon 4. 7 5 is 35 plus 6, 41 upon 7. 6 2 is 12 plus 5, 17 upon 6. 10 5 is 50 plus 3, 53 upon 5. 9 7 is 63 plus 3, 66 upon 7. 9 8 is 72 plus 4. 76 upon 9. In this way we convert mixed fraction into improper fraction. Okay. Thank you, student.